In this video, I'm going to go over how to simplify a fraction to lowest terms. Often this is called reducing a fraction to lowest terms, or you might just say a fraction is simplified if it's in lowest terms. So a fraction is simplified or in lowest terms or reduced if the numerator and denominator have no factors in common except one. All right, so let's look at an example. How about if we took the fraction 3/5, and you look at that, and the only factors in common are one, right? Because they're both prime for one thing. So this is reduced. Now let's look at another one, 10/12. All right, what factors do they have in common? Well, they're both even, so they have a factor of two in common, so this is not reduced. All right, so how are we going to reduce things? Well, to simplify a fraction, we write it an equivalent fraction that has no factors except one in the numerator or denominator. So if you look at 10/12, we decided that 2 was a factor of both of them. So we're going to use our knowledge of equivalent fractions. I went over that in another video where you could multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number. You could also divide the numerator and denominator by the same number. So one way of seeing this, there's a lot of ways to actually do this, is you can write the numerator and denominator with that common factor. So this could be thought of as 2 times 5, and this could be thought of as 2 times 6, correct? And then if I wanted, I could split the fractions this way. I could put 2 over 2 times 5 over 6 and get an answer of 5/6. Now, I'm not suggesting you go through all those steps, but this is one way of showing how you're changing it to an equivalent fraction, and now there are no common factors except one in 5 and 6. All right, now is there an easier way to write that? Yes. Okay. There are lots of ways to do this. Let's do it again. Simplify 10/12. Well, what you could do is say, I'm going to divide the top and bottom by the same number, so I'm going to divide it by 2 over 2. Now remember, that's like dividing by 1. And instead of writing out 10 divided by 2 and 12 divided by 1, let's just do the numerator divide by 2 and the bottom divide by 2. So I have 10 divided by 2 is 5, and 12 divided by 2 is 6. So that's one way of doing it. Often people do this in their head. They think 10/12, and they think, well, in their head, I'm just going to divide both numbers by 2. And again, you're going to get 5/6. All right, how about if we have something that is a little bit bigger? Let's say 36/80, and I want to reduce this. Well, we could do this procedure. We could think of any number that we could divide both the numerator and denominator by. It's not simplified because it's both numbers are even. So we know we could at least divide both numbers by 2. So we could start by dividing both numbers by 2. Can we do that in our head? 36 divided by 2 is 18, and 80 divided by 2 is 40. All right. Now, they're both even again, so I know I could divide by 2 again. So 18 divided by 2 is 9, 40 divided by 2 is 20. Now we see 9/20, and we think, do they have any factors in common? Well, 9 is 3 times 3, and neither of those are factors of 20. So this is the reduced or simplified form for 36/80. So that's one way you might reduce it. Now, you might have noticed that 4 is a common factor of both of these, and you could have divided the top and bottom by 4. And if you want to show it, which I didn't in previously, you could say, okay, I'm going to divide both of them by 4. That's optional if you want to show it. And again, 36 divided by 4 is 9, and 80 divided by 4 is 20. Now, in this problem, it wasn't so hard to figure out what you could divide the numerator and denominator by, either by 2 and do it twice, or divided by 4. Another option for doing 36/80 or any fraction is to prime factor both of the numbers. Okay? I'm going to do that with a factor tree over here. So let's take 36 and prime factor using a factor tree, and you could use any method you want. And so I've got 2 times 3 times 2 times 3. It doesn't matter what order you write the factors in. And let's do 80. I like to think of that as 8 times 10. 10 is 2 times 5. 8 is 2 times 4. And then I'm going to break that down. So I'm going to get these 5 factors for 80. By the way, I didn't circle these, but there were 4 factors for 36. So what does that give me? I have 1, 2, 3, 4 twos, and a 5. So if you prime factor, I'm going to move this down a little bit because I'm running out of space. Now we do what is often called canceling. Anytime you have the same factor in the numerator and the denominator, you can cancel them out. So if you have a factor of 2 in both places, you do it. And you just go across the numerator and see if there's one of those factors that you can cancel in the bottom. There's no 3, right? There's a 2. Is there another 2 in the bottom? Yes. Okay. Is there another 3 in the bottom? No. All right. Now what's left in the numerator gets in the numerator, and what's left in the denominator, if there's more than one thing, you multiply them together. You multiply these 3 that are left, and that's going to give you 3/20. That's a more systematic way of doing it if you're not sure what number goes into both. So let's do another one like that. All right, simplify 48/99. Now there are different ways to do this. You might just think of a number that goes into both 48 and 99, or you could do it by doing the prime factorization first. All right, let's see if we could just figure out a number that goes into both of it and try that. So I'll start with the prime numbers. Does 2 go into each of these? No, because they're not both even. What about 3? Do you remember the divisibility rule for 3? 3 goes into 99, that's easy to see, but it also goes into 48. And one way of doing it is, remember, you could add the digits. 4 plus 8 is 12, and 3 goes into 12. So that means it also gets into 48. So what I can do is start off by dividing the top and bottom by 3, if you want. And that'll give you 16 33rds. All right, now, I want to know if we could reduce this any further. So you think, is there a number that goes into both of them? I don't see any number that goes into both of them, but if you prime factor, you're sure of it. So 16 is 4 times 4. So you're going to get 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. What's going on with my pen here today? And 33 is 3 times 11. So you know what? They don't have any factors in common, so this is going to be the reduced answer. Now, what if instead of just trying to figure out what you could divide both by, you just always prime factored first? That's great. You could say, well, 48 is, and think of any number goes into 48, so how about 24 and 2? And then 24 would be 4 times 6. 4 would be 2 times 2. Notice I'm circling them once they are prime. And so I could just write the prime factorization of 48. Notice there are 1, 2, 3, 4 factors of 2 and a 3. And then I could do the same thing for 99. 3 goes into 99, or you could say 9 times 11. Most people might see 9 times 11 first, and 11's prime, and then 3 times 3. So for 99, if you prime factored it, you'd have 3 times 3 times 11. And then you can cancel anything that's exactly the same as one of the factors in the denominator, and 3 is it. When you're done, then you have to multiply whatever's left. So I have to go back and multiply those 4 twos and multiply the 3 times 11 to get 33. So it depends which is easier for you. Is it easier to try to think of what number goes into each of them and then just divide the numerator and denominator by that same number? Or do you want to just go ahead and prime factor and then cancel common factors? And in this case, you do notice there's kind of more work involved, right? But it's more foolproof as well. You might not miss something. When the numbers are small enough, it's easier to just be able to tell what number goes into both of them and to divide. It's when you have larger numbers, especially, that you might want to do it by prime factorization if you're not sure where to start. So I'm going to do some more reducing of fractions on the next video.